كل شيء من خلقه وبدا خلق الانسان من طين واصلي واسلم على المبعوث رحمه للعالمين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين وبعد I bear witness that there is none worthy of our worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and I bear witness that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is the seal of the prophets and the final messenger to all of humanity wherever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides There is no one to misguide, and whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leads to stray, there is none to guide aright. يقول الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم موثق القائلين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما عليه الصلاة والسلام وبعد this week inshallah this coming week in the next few days we'll be commemorating the honorable event or memory of the birth of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and this is something we should do actually every day commemorate the mission the life and the legacy of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to teach his example to our children to learn from his example whether you are a father a husband a business person and so on and so forth whatever you do regardless of your job regardless of your status in life there is always something that you can learn from Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the Quran in so many different ways Number one, the ayah we just recited, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ Which is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has never mentioned with any prophet in the Quran. This is exclusive to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم that Allah showers him with his rahmah. And the malaika pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower his rahmah on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding us in the Quran to give salah and salam to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم tells us in the authentic hadith, if you give salah and salam to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, sallallahu alayhi biya ashra, Allah will give you salam back 10 times for every time you make salam to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you salam back, it means He's showering you with His rahmah, fala yamassaka al-'adhab. So He will never punish you. So now you have this shafa'ah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Also in the Quran, Whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks to a prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would call them by their first name. Ya Musa, do this and this. Ya Yahya, khudh al-kitab bi-quwa. Ya Ibrahim, Ya Isa ibn Maryam, Ya Zakariya, and so on and so forth. Allah would call them by their first name. And this never happened with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran, not once. He always called him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always calls him in the Quran either Be Ya Ayyuha Nabi or Ya Ayyuha Rasul. Either O Prophet or O Messenger. To show him, you know, to give him this honor by using these titles for the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And I always wonder, in the translations of the Quran, when they translate, and when Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala is telling the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, قل, if say this or do this, and they, between brackets, they say, O Muhammad. Well, Allah never speaks to him this way in the Quran. That you should say, O Messenger, or O Prophet, just like Allah speaks to him in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honors the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You look at the example of some other prophets in the Quran, they make dua. And in the case of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would answer his dua, or he would grant something to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even without him asking. So Musa alayhi salam would say, Ya Allah, قال رب اشرح لي صدري يا رب uplift my heart for me and in the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam alam nashrah laka sadrak didn't we already uplift your heart for you and there are so many examples for this in the Quran prophets making dua for certain things and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would receive this honor or this blessing even without asking the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam inna a'tainaka al-kawthar everyone knows this surah And this is the shortest surah in the Quran. And the ulama say that this surah is the stickyard for reciting after Fatiha. Like if you read ayat after Fatiha, minimum words you should recite is 10 words. or more, because surah Inna A'tainaka al-Kawthar is the shortest and it's only 10 words. So now they say that the Prophet ﷺ, he suffered a lot in his life, challenges and difficulties and hardships, just like the other prophets of Ulul Azm min al-Rusul. And the Prophet ﷺ suffered the most among them, and he faced the most challenges among these prophets. And Ulul Azm min al-Rusul, the top five prophets of Islam, Ulul Azm, Nuh wa Ibrahim wa Musa wa Isa alayhi wa Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa salatu wa salam. Fasbir kama sabara ulul azm min ar-rusul. The challenges were so many and difficulties were so many as well, and the successes were so great. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is one of ulul azm min ar-rusul. So if you look at these prophets, and I'll tell you why inshallah I'm mentioning these stories and sharing these stories.